Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, my friends, thank you for the time and opportunity. Warm I respect for full lecturer Bapak Dr. Andika Hardin, SIP MPUM, thank you. And warm I love my friends. First of all, let us give thanks for the presence of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And don't forget to send salawat and taslim Prophet wa namli Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, to the point, let's to go today will presentation the result of my group work. All question will be reading by only one person as a representative. Introduce the name of our my group, namely group 2, Marwa, Muhammad Safri, Syaharani Winda, and Nur Hidayah Amelia. A title about phonetic and phonology. Okay, to the point. On behalf of presenter number one, Muhammad Safri, please, you are reading this is question and answer.
Okay, question regarding lesson one. Number one, what do you know of the communication, language, and linguistics? What are their differences and how are they related to one another? And number two, referring to question, in question one, in what area does phonetics and phonology belong? Please explain your answer in detail. In number three, do phonetics and phonology and pronunciation exist in the same area or context? Please explain your answer in detail. Give example if necessary. Number four, what do you know of phonetics and pronunciation? What are their difference? How are they related to each other? In number five, what do you know of phonology and pronunciation? What are their difference? How are they related to each other? In the last, number six, what are the implications of phonetics and phonology in teaching English pronunciation? Please explain your answer in detail, if necessary. My answer in question number one, meaning of communication is the process of conveying meaning from one entity or group to another through the use of signs, symbol, and semiotic rules that are understood together. And language is the ability that humans have to communicate with other humans using signs such as words and movements. And linguistic or linguist is the study of language, depends on a researcher point of view and approach. And the last, language is a communication system that relies on verbal or non-verbal codes to transfer information, while communication is a way of exchanging message of information between two or more people. Okay, this is my answer. Back to moderator.
Thank you, Muhammad Safri. You're reading question. Next, presenter number two, Syaharani Winda. Please, your the answer.
Okay, thanks moderator for the opportunity to give it to me. And my answer number three, phonetics and phonology are both the study of sound. In phonetics, objective ways are proficient to describe and analyze the range of human voices used in their language and to find out the sound changes in a word. Learning about the process of sound formation, delivery or pronunciation, and pronunciation is pronunciation in English, which includes articulation, emphasis, and intonation. Number four, as described earlier, that phonetics and phonology are the branch of a scientific study which specifically examines sounds in language. On the other hand, pronunciation is one of language skills. Basically, language skill consists of three types, namely productive skills, receptive skill, as well as productive plus receptive skills. To clarify the position of pronunciation, it's good to briefly describe about two skills. Among the three language skills, it turns out that pronunciation is one of micro skills of speaking skills. That's all for me. Back to moderator.
Okay, thank you, Syaharani Binda. You are to answer. Next, presenter number three, Nur Hidayah Amelia, please your answer.
Okay, thank you. My answer is phonetic and phonology are both the study of sound. In phonetic, objective was our profit to describe and analyze the range of human voice used in their language and to find out the sound change is in a word, learning about the process of sound formation, delivery or pronunciation, and pronunciation is pronunciation in English, which included articulation, emphasis, and intonation. An example of phonology is how we pronounce a language and how it can appear and disappear. Thank you. That's all from me. Back to moderator.
Presenter number three, Nur Hidayah Amelia, your answer this very perfect. Okay, next presenter number four to me, to the answer. To the answer next. Phonology and pronunciation have differences in how to pronounce a word or create the language. Pronunciation has many ways, while phonology only has only way, namely focusing on the part of the body that can produce sound. The relationship is the same as it relates to the scansy of the language. There are something can produce sound. Next answer, in my opinion, the implication of learning of phonetic phonology in teaching English pronunciation, our student can distinguish the difference between phonetic phonology and pronunciation. In the other hand, learning phonetic will help Indonesian learners of English sound more natural when speaking English because phonetic makes them aware of the different sound that English make use of. For example, them, they solve pronounce the word they, the word presency, but not they. And I hope Indonesian learners of English are, example, able to minimize their error in appendition English word. That was the presentation from our my group. Well, that result of discussion about phonetic and phonology. Thank you so much. Wait, apakah dari teman-teman sekalian masih ada yang ingin ditambahkan ataukah ada tanggapan-tanggapan jawaban lain? Okay, do you have any public friends? Well, if there is no response or input, I will close this presentation by saying Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin. Thank you so much, my friends, to the opportunity and to the time. Thank you for the time. Saya akhiri dengan ucapan wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.